how we say so, and we have a lovely gathering with us here. So Mr. Victor, there is a lot of buzz around Abacus. So what is the whole concept about?
The whole concept is basically how to convert number, which is actually an abstract concept,
sure,
to something which you can picturize. That's a simple, that's a
okay,
very baseline. But really the big idea is to develop mental skills in kids, which can help them to learn things more faster. What mental skills are talking of? Things like concentration, their visual memory, their listening skills, and also their, I would say the fear of numbers going, and that actually helps them improve the self-confidence.
So, Major, you're from the army, so give us some tips for kids.
Right, you know, I have a 7-year-old son and he also enrolled into Abacus.
Sure.
And maths used to be my weakness when I was small. In fact, I got a compartment exam in class 10th.
Sure.
But maths is my son's strongest point. I'll tell you the reason behind this. See, when you talk in English or you talk in Hindi, it is a child's favorite subject because you can visualize the boy entered the room, the cat sat on the mat. You can imagine a cat sitting on a mat. But the moment you say 2 plus 4 plus minus 8 plus 6 plus into 14, you start getting stress on your mind even though you had learned multiplication, subtraction, addition in class 1.
Absolutely.
Even now, because the reason is simple logic. You cannot picturize those numbers.
Sure.
Now, Abacus is the only way and means which helps you picturize that. Okay, the picture that comes before child's mind. And because the picture comes, now math is becoming the favorite subject.
Yes.
Instead of having Hindi,
yeah,
English,
yeah,
other things that have, now they're doing excelling in maths. And secondly, they say, you know, in today's world, a child is glued to technology.
Absolutely.
iPad, mobile, tab, and
sure,
he's weakening his eyes, and you know, and the brain stops functioning at the same speed before you use that gadget. Here you don't use an electronic device. The Abacus is busy. It's like a toy. Play with it. And automatically your mind is getting sharpened with that.
Right.
And secondly, I think it is not a business deal at all.
Sure.
I think it is something with which you are giving back to society. Because when you find your children and match the subject, no matter what you do, it will never leave you. You take arts. You want to avoid maths. But, come on, you are talking about your tax, your economics. It's something which is, I think,
you can't run away from
numbers. You cannot run away from number. And you could not have a better person who's an ex-IIM.
Right.
Ex-IIM.
Yes.
Like Sir Drew.
Yes. Earlier today, you were sharing a nice episode about arts.
Would you like to share with our viewers? It is about a very nice story which really taught me itself the power of Abacus, where one of our students ended up becoming one of the top artists. So her very simple and very interesting story was when I was in class 6, I used to be like an average student in school, mid of the class like everybody else. But I also liked art, but my mom was not very encouraging of it because I wasn't doing very well at school. So I joined the SIP Abacus program and I could see that slowly my grades were improving. I was moving to the middle of the class and the top 10 and the top 5. And I was improving in the class, my parents also allowed me to pursue my education. So when it came to class 10, this girl from Hyderabad, so when it came to class 10, I was doing so well that I actually came first in school. And usually when you're first in school, obviously everybody says you're doing pretty well inside. So I actually ended up doing arts, physics and chemistry in the 11th and 12th, even though that wasn't really my interest. But I pursued art parallelly because my parents allowed me to because of university. And when I finished 12th, I did well at school, I was class school 3rd, but my passion lay with art. And hence I decided to follow art and Singapore. And today I'm obviously a great artist, but I must thank the Abacus program,
sure,
for allowing me to pursue the interest of art. And the beauty, she says, that
Abacus should thank you.
And she says, the beauty is today when I am an artist, I'm also very strong with numbers. A lot of people, my professors, they are quite surprised how you can be so good at numbers and you're really an artist. And like I always tell that it's possible. It's just that we should give the right training to kids. And they can do multiple things.
Sure.
So that way, this is a great, I would say, almost an essential skill that people need to have. And they can build other skills. You can be great in theatre, like Major Shah here, learn great art, or you can be a musician. Doesn't matter. But there's no harm in having an additional skill. I would say no harm. It's a great addition to you to have an additional skill like this. You can actually be with you all your life.
Absolutely. So, Mr. Kevin, tell us about the origin of Abacus and also about the competition.
So, well, the origin of Abacus, if you see, it was not many years back. So, the VCs and the Chinese actually used for calculating their stuff and how much of stock came, how much went, how much money they made. And all. But that the calculator was obviously not there. The only instrument that they used for the calculations was Abacus. And there were a lot of versions of Abacus that actually came out from the Japanese Abacus. Slowly and slowly people started adopting the methodologies and the practices that they used. And then they started coming and going to places. And that's when the thing of Abacus and how they can improve. Or I should not use the word improve. I should rather put across as how to develop your love for maths.
Yes. Right. And tell us about your competition as well.
So the competition out here, if you see the Abacus players and all, I don't see any that competition.
This competition.
Yes.
Yeah. Well, the competition about this competition is actually comparing to around 5 years long. Coming from the
sure.
20 different schools, they have 65 course instructors. So these people are the heart of this competition. So this competition is helpful actually. One of the first things that I would say is develop that competitive spirit. It also lets us know that the quality of the delivery, right? So ideally, if the 5 times better is what we say every practice promise, and every parent who gets this child over here, we go pre-test and we deliver them 5 times better, otherwise we return the money for cash back in all the places. So we see that we need to stand by that promise and we need to deliver by it. That's the ideology that we follow when we do these competitions. It's not to say that this is doing better than the others, you know. It's just that they should be better than themselves.
Absolutely. That's a wonderful point. And we have a lovely, gorgeous mom here, Rajalaxmi. So, give us some parenting tips, and I believe your daughter has also done and learned a lot more. So, you share with us.
Initially, my daughter was pretty scared of maths. Like, all the time she used to keep thinking of, you know, ways and means, and even you know, she used to think of professions where she would not need to take up maths. Yeah. She used to come up and ask that if I do this, would I still need maths? Would say, you know, because daily life would
actually
be great. Yeah. But then you know, like she we enrolled her to this course. And then there, you know, like when I used to attend some of their orientation workshops, I realized that initially they use the actual Abacus, and then later the child starts, they have to imagine the Abacus. They have to visualize the Abacus actually. So then they are, and initially they develop using the fingers, you know,
yes.
So then that they are able to, this finger and the mind and that coordination. So that develops in the earlier stages, and then later you are able to use the right side of your brain as well as the calculator. So then the right and left side, you know, that all of that.
All the visualization happens in the right side, because if you look at the right side, it's all creative thing, visualizing.
Yeah.
So the right side actually gets used a lot.
Yes. So then they start using both sides of their brain equally, I would say, or you know, in a better way.
Better way.
Yeah, better way. So they know how to deal with it. So then they don't get stuck with numbers as such. And then that fear, you know, gradually goes away. And that actually, you know, the fear is basically something that holds people back. So then once, you know, they start realizing that nothing is not as dreadful as it should have been.
Very
as it looks. Excel or something.
best in the world, I would say, or it's equal to the best in the world. And that's what we believe the SAP app is for the case. What we are currently making, it is actually true in many ways. And if you look at growth, we are actually growing really well. We start simply because of references. A lot of people are running our business are referring to parents to join us or referring other franchises to join us. And we do expect even in Mumbai, even though we have 17 centers, there is a lot of space to grow in the city. It's a group city and a lot of children. And I'm sure a lot of parents who want to develop their kids at a young age, their skills at a young age. So I think our big focus is in the future is really our India social culture. Even though we have 720 centers across the country, it still is a drop in the ocean for the size of our nation. So I think we have enough work for many more years. Even if we don't do anything else, this is another new service that we can do for the country.
Final words for you, Abacus, final words for you.
I would like to applaud them and really praise them for their efforts. Because like starting any new venture, there's teething trouble, right? So they say a journey to a 1,000 miles starts with a single step.
Yes.
Similarly, there's a sheer in Urdu by Majnun Sultanpuri which says, "Main to akele hi chala tha jaane pe manzil. Main to akele hi chala tha jaane pe manzil, magar log saath aate gaye aur karwa banta gaya." I really hope I got close for the prosperity of society.
Perfectly, very well said, and happily said.
On that note, we will wrap up. Thank you so much for watching.
Thank you.
Thank you.